Now let's take up some questions on surds. Alright. The questions on surds can be divided into three categories. The first category is the questions related to comparison. Okay. Second category of questions will be based on rationalization of irrational numbers. We'll take all of them one by one. And the third category of questions is based on finding the square root of irrational numbers. Square root of irrational numbers. Okay. Now let's take one by one. First, we'll start from the questions related to comparison. Now, let's take up the first question. It says, arrange the following numbers. Numbers are root 3, cube root of 7, fourth root of 12, and sixth root of 20. Right? Now, we have to arrange them in, let's say, in ascending order. Alright? Let's give them some name. Root 3 is, let's say, A. The cube root of 7 is B, 4th root of 12 is C, and 6th root of 20 is D. So, we have to arrange A, B, C, D in the ascending order. Now, how do we go about it? Let's see. First, let's write them in terms of powers. Square root of 3 can be written as 3 to the power 1 by 2. Cube root of 7 can be written as 7 to the power 1 by 3. 4th root of 12 can be written as 12 to the power 1 by 4. And 6th root of 20 can be written as 20 to the power 1 by 6. As we have studied earlier, that nth root of A is actually A raised to the power 1 by n. Okay. Now here, look at the powers. The powers are 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, and 1 by 6. Look at the denominator of the powers. 2, 3, 4, and 6. Let's make them equal. And how do we make them equal? We calculate the LCM of 2, 3, 4, 6. The LCM of 2, 3, 4, 6 is 12. Now, to make 12 in all the denominators, how do we make it? Let's see. This 1 by 2 can be written as 6 by 12. So, it is 3 to the power 6 by 12. The 7 to the power 1 by 3, this can be written as 7 to the power 4 by 12. We are saying that 1 by 3 can be written as 4 by 12. Then this 1 by 4, this can be written as 3 by 12. And this 20 to the power 1 by 6 can be written as 20 to the power 2 by 12. Now, these numbers, all of them can be written as, let's see, 3 to the power 6 by 12 can be written as 3 to the power 6 whole to the power 1 by 12, 7 to the power 4 whole to the power 1 by 12, the next number can be written as 12 to the power 3 whole to the power 1 by 12, and next number can be written as 20 square whole to the power 1 by 12, because we also know that A raised to the power x whole to the power y is equal to A to the power x into y. And this applies both ways. Right? So now this 3 raised to 6 is 729 to the power 1 by 12. 7 raised to 4 is 49 square, that is 2401 raised to the power 1 by 12. 12 cube is 1728 raised to the power 1 by 12. 20 square is 400 raised to the power 1 by 12. Right? You see, in this situation, all these numbers have the same power, right? So, the number which has smaller base will be smaller, the number which has higher base will be higher, right? Here, 2401 is the highest, right? 400 is the smallest, okay? So, if I have to arrange them in the order, if this was A, this was B, this was C, this was D, then the ascending order for these numbers will be given as, the smallest will come first. That is, D is the smallest, then it is A, then larger than A it is C, and the largest would be B. So, this is the ascending order answer for this question. Okay. So, this was one very beautiful method. What we need to do, see, understand, in any case what we have to do is, we have to either make the bases equal or the power equal. Right? We can compare two numbers only when either the bases are equal or the powers are equal. When both are different, then the question will become very difficult. And in our exams, we will not be asked such questions. We will be asked such questions where we can either we can equate the base and compare the powers, or we can equate the power and compare the bases. Here we have equated the power. We have made all the powers equal to 1 by 12, right? And then we have compared the bases. On that basis, the answer is D is smallest number, then A larger than D, then C larger than A, and B is the largest number. So this is the ascending order in this particular case. Right? Let's take one more question. Now, this question says, arrange the following numbers in ascending order. Right? Let's say the first number is A, that is root 7 plus root 17. Second number is root 10 plus root 14, let's call it B. Third number is 3 plus root 15, let's call it C. And 4 plus 2 root 2, that is D. Right? We will use a formula that is x plus y whole square. We know that it is equal to x square plus y square plus 2xy. Now, how do we use it here? Let's see. What we will do is we'll square all of these numbers. Now, what will be the square of A, the first one? Root 7 plus root 17. Let me write it properly. Root 7 plus root 17 whole square. Now, from this formula, x square plus b square plus 2xy, what do we get? Root 7 square is 7. Root 17 square is 17 plus 2 root 7 into root 17. This gives us 7 plus 17 is 24 plus 2 root 7 and 17 will be multiplied, right? We have studied earlier that root of A into root of B can be taken as root of A into B, right? So they'll combine and give us 7 into 17, that is 119. This is the square of the first number, all right? Now the second number, what will be the square of this number? Let me write it again, root 10 plus root 14. If you take the whole square, root 10 square is 10, root 14 square is 14 plus 2 root 10 into root 14. This gives us 10 plus 14 is 24 plus 2 root 10 into 14 is 140, right? So this is the square of the second number, okay? The third one, 3 plus root 15 whole square. Now you see it will be 3 square is 9. Root 15 square is 15 plus 2 into 3 into root 15. Now let's do one thing. Send this 3 inside the root. Now when 3 goes inside the root, it becomes 3 square. So it becomes 9 plus 15 is 24 plus. Now 3 goes 2 times 3 goes inside becomes 9. 9 into 15 is root 135. Right? I will write it separately. Let's say here. When I say 2 into 3 root 15, what we do is we send this 3 inside the bracket. When it goes inside, it becomes 3 square, right? Now, 3 square is 9. So, it is 2 into 9 into 15. And 9 into 15 is 135. So, that is what we have used here. The fourth one, that is 4 plus 2 root 2 whole square. 4 square is 16. 2 root 2 square will be 2 into 2 square is 4 and root 2 square is 2. So, it is 8. Plus 2 into 4 into 2 root 2, right? Now here again, this 4 into 2 is 8. Let this 2 be here. See, we want 2 in every number, right? So this 2 be here. This 4 into 2 is 8. 8 goes inside, becomes 8 square, that is 64. So we have 16 plus 8, that is 24, plus 2 times root of. Now 4 into 2 is 8. 8 goes inside, becomes 8 square. 8 square is 64 into 2, that is 128, all right? So, this is 24 plus 2 root 128. I'll just show how we got this 2 into 4 into 2 root 2. This is actually 2 into 4 into 2 is 8 root 2. This 8 goes inside the square root. So, it becomes 2 into root of 8 square into 2, which is 2 into square root of 8 square is 64 into 2, that is 128. So, it is 2 root 128. All right. This is how we got this 2 root 128. Now, these are the squares. These are the square numbers. Look at them carefully. Here you see 24 is the first part in each number. Then plus 2 times is there in each number. Then square root of different numbers. So, whichever number has a smaller number inside square root will be smaller. And whichever number has a higher number inside the square root will be higher. So, from here you see 24 is same. 2 is same. So, inside the square root, the smallest is 119. Right? And the largest is 140, right? So very clearly you can see that the ascending order will be given as the smallest was this one, that is root 119, and that came from A. So it will be A first, then larger than A. Let's look at the number or find the number which is more than 119. Now more than 119 is 128. So the second place will be 128. This has come from D. So it is D. Then the next number would be more than 128 is 135. So that has come from C. So it is less than C. And then largest one that has come from B, because it is 140 has come from B. So it is B. So the ascending order is given as A less than D less than C less than B. See, in your exams, the questions will be asked like this only. It'll either be the first part same or the second part same, right? So if one of the parts is same, then it's very easy. It becomes very easy to compare which number is larger and which number is smaller. So this is how the questions will be asked from you. All right. Let's take one more question on comparison of surds. Let's say we have A is equal to root 17 minus root 15 and B is equal to root 13 minus root 11, right? Which one is greater? We have to find which one is greater. Now, here we have minus sign. Earlier the question that we did, we had plus sign, root 17 plus root 15 kind of numbers were there. But here we have root 17 minus root 15. Please be careful that the method will not be the same as we did earlier. Here what we need to do is, we need to multiply by the conjugate in numerator and denominator. So this A, which is equal to root 17 minus root 15, just multiply by the conjugate of that number, that is root 17 plus root 15, and divide by root 17 plus root 15, right? So this A becomes in numerator it will be root 17 minus root 15 into root 17 plus root 15, that will be x minus y into x plus y, which is x square minus y square. So it is root 17 square minus root 15 square divide by root 17 plus root 15. I repeat, whenever there is a minus sign, you simply multiply by the conjugate in numerator and denominator. So in numerator, we will have 17 minus 15 divide by denominator will be root 17 plus root 15. The purpose is to get an irrational number with a plus sign. So A is equal to 2 divide by root 17 plus root 15. Right? So here in denominator, we have an irrational number which has a plus sign in it. Alright? And numerator is 2. Now let's look at the other number, that is B. So B is root 13 minus root 11. Right? Follow the same procedure. The same B can be taken as root 13 minus root 11 multiply by root 13 plus root 11 divide by root 13 plus root 11. Right? So what happens? We get B equal to root 13 minus root 11 into root 13 plus root 11 will be root 13 square minus root 11 square. And in denominator, we will have root 13 plus root 11. Alright, so B is equal to root 13 square is 13, root 11 square is 11 divided by root 13 plus root 11. So here also, we have 2 in the numerator and denominator is an irrational number with plus sign. Right? Now we have to compare A and B, and now we can do that very easily. Let's see. Look at this A and B very carefully. The numerator is same, that is 2, right? Now whichever has a larger denominator, that number will be smaller, right? Larger denominator, that means the number smaller. Now look at the denominators. What are the denominators? Denominators are root 17 plus root 15 in the first one. And root 13 plus root 11 in the second one. Very clearly, you know, you can see that root 13 is smaller than root 17. Root 11 is smaller than root 15. So their sum will definitely be smaller than this whole thing. So we can say here, just by looking at it, that root 17 plus root 15 is greater than root 13 plus root 11. Right? I repeat. See, here we have root 17. We know it is greater than root 13. We also know that root 15 is greater than root 11. Right? Inequalities can be added, right? They cannot be subtracted, but they can be definitely added. So if I add the numbers on right and left hand side, it will be root 17 plus root 15 and it will be greater than root 13 plus root 11. So remember, inequalities can be added only when they have the same sign and they can be only added. They cannot be subtracted or any other thing, right? So root 17 plus root 15 is definitely greater than root 13 plus root 11. Now this means that 2 divided by root 17 plus root 15 will be less than 2 divided by root 13 plus root 11. Why? Because if the denominator is high, the number is small. Okay. So this shows that A is less than B. Alright. So here the answer is A less than B. So this was a much simpler question actually.